together, we want to extend a warm welcome to all of you. Thank you for coming to this special benefit to honor Secretary of Defense William Perry, to salute all of the frontline healthcare workers who are keeping us safe, and to advance our joint work, IPPNWs and GBPSRs, our joint work on the twin existential threats of nuclear war and climate change. The pandemic and runaway climate change are wreaking havoc across the country and around the world. Poorer countries, poorer communities, and people of color are suffering disproportionately. Yet despite the horrors going on all around us, the United States and the other nuclear armed states are on a massive spending spree in a renewed quest for military and nuclear supremacy, which in reality makes every one of us, every person on this tiny interdependent planet, profoundly less safe.
The Back from the Brink resolution, which combines nuclear weapons safety issues advocated by arms control experts with the clear, unambiguous goal of eliminating nuclear weapons entirely, has been adopted throughout the country in cities large and small.
A few of our climate action items include collaboration on numerous publications for the public and the medical community, and initiating resolutions brought before the Massachusetts Medical Society. Recently, we produced a series of reports outlining the anticipated health and environmental impacts of the Weymouth Compressor Station. GBPSR has been a key player in articulating the health benefits of electrification. We developed web pages and presentations and have advocated at the city and state level for a net zero carbon building stretch code. We seem to have lost sight of the fact that we are all dependent on others, that our lives are all connected, something that the current pandemic has made all too clear.
And that in turn drives these three dangerous policies. The president has the sole authority, as we've mentioned, to launch nuclear weapons within minutes with no second opinions or oversight. The president can order a first strike and is not limited to retaliation. And third, that the president can launch hundreds of ICBMs, land-based ballistic missiles, on warning of attack without waiting for proof of attack.
Years ago, during the Cold War, when I was the Undersecretary of Defense, I was awoken at 3 o'clock in the morning. As I picked up the phone sleepily, the voice on the other end identified himself as the watch officer at the North American Air Defense Command. And the first thing he said to me was his computers were showing 200 ICBMs on the way from the Soviet Union to the United States. I will never, ever forget that moment. Happily, he then went on to tell me that he had concluded it was a false alarm. And the reason he was calling me was he hoped I might be able to help him figure out what had gone wrong. So it was a machine error. We also have had human errors cause false alarms. A year before that, when the computer operator came on shift that evening, he put into the computer what he thought was the operating tape for the computer, and it turned out instead to be a training tape. And so the computer was showing a perfectly realistic scenario of an attack unfolding. In both of those cases, we avoided actually starting an accidental war, but it was a close call. But no president should ever have to make that decision. No person should have to make that decision, especially in the middle of the night without any possibility to consult, with any possibility to get context in what's happening.
Perhaps not in your lifetime, and perhaps in the lifetime of your granddaughter, we'll see the abolition of nuclear weapons. That is our hope.
Maybe even in your lifetime and Tom's lifetime. How about that?
On behalf of Longwood Symphony, I'm glad to bring you the world premiere of the LSO Virtual Brass Ensemble. They are performing La Paris Fanfare by Paul Dukas. So please enjoy our virtual performance. Thank you.